Hi guys, welcome to Learn English with M to the power of 3. In today's lesson, we will learn and practice English with
Ark. In a mysterious primeval land populated by dinosaurs and other extinct creatures, people from throughout human history have been brought back to life. When 21st century Australian paleontologist Helena Walker awakes there after tragedy, she must learn to survive and find new allies or die again at the hands of ruthless warlords, all while trying to uncover the true nature of their strange new world.
But before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and bell down below, because every week there's a new video here on the channel. So what are you waiting for? Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a single new video. Now let's get started.
Number 1. What a pity. And number 2, alas. Let's watch.
Where am I?
What a pity that one of the first questions you ask me, I, alas, cannot answer.
What a pity. Pity means feeling sorry for someone else's bad situation. The expression "what a pity" is used to show that you feel sorry or sad about something unfortunate that happened. Let's watch some examples.
All of these decisions that you seem to make and then resent us for. They do not make you worthy of your family's respect. They simply make us pity you.
I feel like an idiot.
Oh, come on, you're not an idiot. Look, just help me put it back up.
Why? So you can just take it down when I leave? I don't need your pity.
Oh, Amy, come on.
And you kill the information.
What a pity that would be.
Oh, what a pity to have missed it. Oh.
Oh, what a pity you did not bring your music.
That is an interesting idea, but it's a big decision and I'm leaving tomorrow.
Oh, what pity.
Alas, it's an expression used to show sadness, regret or disappointment. It often introduces bad news or an unfortunate situation. It's not used much in everyday talk. It sounds a bit old-fashioned or formal. People usually say unfortunately or I'm sorry instead. Let's watch some examples.
Master of the Mercer's Guild, is he not?
Was. The poor man has died, alas.
My father heard it. Do you think that's who's calling me?
Maybe. Alas, only Atta Hollin knows.
Atta Hollin?
Where were you?
Alas, I was forced to occupy my day with tedious wedding errands, which Mama has listed me for yet again.
But alas, I am gonna miss having the world's best roomie.
Alas. Earwax.
Now let's watch that scene again.
Where am I?
What a pity that one of the first questions you ask me, I, alas, cannot answer.
Number 3. Nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. Let's watch.
To become one of the most exciting voices in her field.
And she has a reputation for being as nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs.
Nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. This phrase means someone is extremely nervous or anxious, like a cat with a long tail worried about its tail getting caught under the rocking chairs. Let's watch some examples.
This is crazy, it's a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs.
Oh, she looks as nervous as
a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs.
Sorry, I'm as nervous as a cat in a room full of rocking chairs.
I don't think how you'd feel if your entire teaching career were riding on this.
Now let's watch that scene again.
To become one of the most exciting voices in her field.
And she has a reputation for being as nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs.
Number 4. To spare someone. Let's watch.
You little viper, you think to poison my wine?
No, I didn't poison the wine, General.
After I spared you.
To spare someone.
It means to save them from pain or trouble, allow them to escape harm, damage or death, or show them mercy by avoiding something unpleasant. Let's watch some examples.
Sparing you, but I can see now that I was really sparing myself.
Oh, spare me, Lily. You'd be doing the same thing if you were in this situation.
That's outrageous. There is not a person on Earth I would hide under a table from.
Oh,
you still told her I lied.
For a noble purpose. To spare me the social embarrassment of having a drug-addled first cousin, which I'm assuming is embarrassing, yes?
Perhaps this is a mercy, sparing you from a deeper pain.
You may spare me the instruction, Lady Danbury. I know I am to be on my best behavior.
They'll spare him.
Really? They'll just let him go?
Now let's watch that scene again.
You little viper, you think to poison my wine?
No, I didn't poison the wine, General.
After I spared you.
Number 5. Stay put. Let's watch.
Or you can stay here.
One second. Scary, stay put. I'll be back for you.
Stay put. It means to remain in the same place and not move or leave. Let's watch some examples.
All right, you two. I'm gonna get going.
Oh.
Oh, no, sweetheart. You stay put. I'll let myself out.
Oh, just stay put. Keep the kids inside.
And tell us why you're taking credit for Lee's murder.
Looks like we got a runner.
Stay put.
Next time I tell you to stay put, you stay put.
I can't believe you traveled the entire country and never left the train station.
I know. You know, I almost died in a fire in Des Moines, but I stayed put.
So I stayed put for like 13 hours straight.
Now let's watch that scene again.
Or you can stay here.
One second. Scary, stay put. I'll be back for you.
Number 6. So-called. Let's watch.
The red artifact belongs to Kor, the so-called prophet.
So-called. It means that the name or title might not be true or accurate. For example, the so-called expert means the person might not really be an expert. It can also be used to indicate that something or someone is commonly referred to by a specific name or term, even if the speaker is not necessarily questioning its accuracy. For example, the so-called miracle drug means that the drug is commonly called a miracle drug. So the meaning depends on the context. Let's watch some examples.
All right then, my so-called friends have forsaken me. So I guess it'll just be me and my eyewitness.
Now, we've hit 3 of your so-called safe houses and all of them are empty.
What were you doing visiting that printer shop in the middle of your brother's so-called wedding?
Oh,
I know it is you.
The so-called expert I just consulted insisted emotions can't be controlled.
The so-called Mystery X? Mm-hmm.
Because I've done nothing but support you through this so-called difficult time.
Now let's watch that scene again.
The red artifact belongs to Kor, the so-called prophet.
Number 7. For all the good it does or did. Let's watch.
And it may as well be on the moon for all the good it does us in his hands.
For all the good it does or did. It means that something is ineffective or doesn't have any positive impact, despite efforts made. For example, I told him to be careful, but for all the good it does, he still got hurt. Let's watch some examples.
For all the good it does, one day, if things go well, we'll rule France and Scotland and we'll be together.
So it is now your lightsaber.
For all the good it did me.
You might as well cut the damn thing off for all the good it does me now.
For all the good it does us.
Not quite.
For whatever good it does, if we don't arrest Pierce's fault, okay, he's gonna know we're onto him.
Now let's watch that scene again.
And it may as well be on the moon for all the good it does us in his hands.
Number 8. To have a knack for something. Let's watch.
We heard a huge explosion. Should have known. You've always had a knack for finding trouble.
We found something, John. A weapon.
To have a knack for something. It means to have a natural talent or skill for doing something easily and well. For example, she has a knack for painting means she is naturally good at painting.
Because keeping you from jumping off a cliff keeps my mind off of the fact that my girlfriend's magical coma is linked to a Bennett witch that has a knack for avoiding permanent death.
I see. You've really got a knack for this, brother.
Oh my God, you do a great Chandler.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I have a knack for impressions.
Bolin has a knack for getting into stupid situations.
Getting on my nerves.
I have a knack for that.
People have been swinging at me for years. They always seem to miss.
Choosing your opponents wisely, then.
I have a knack for it.
Now let's watch that scene again.
We heard a huge explosion. Should have known. You've always had a knack for finding trouble.
We found something, John. A weapon.
All right. Now it's time to practice and take the quiz. It has 3 questions and you have 5 seconds to answer each. Are you ready? Here it is. Number 1. What does stay put mean? A. Move quickly. B. Leave immediately. Or C. Remain in the same place. Well done. The correct option is C. So, stay put means remain in the same place. Number 2. What is the meaning of so-called in this context?
We've hit 3 of your so-called safe houses.
A. Commonly called but maybe not true. B. Officially named. Or C. Recently built. Good job! The answer is A. Number 3. Which one is a synonym for alas? A. Happily. B. Unfortunately. Or C. Luckily. That's right. The answer is B. So, alas means unfortunately. You've made it until the end of the lesson. You can share this video with a friend who is also learning English and who maybe is a fan of ARC. Now I have a question for you guys. What have you learned in today's lesson that was new to you? And do you have any questions? Leave us your comment here under this video and we'll curiously read your comments. Thanks for watching! Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. If you like to keep learning, check out this video next. See you in the next one!